गुड मॉर्निंग 11th क्लास. द टॉपिक वी आर स्टार्टिंग टुडे इज एम्पीरिकल एंड मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला. दिस वन इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर योर एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. नाउ इन दिस, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला? ओके, नाउ मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला, यू कैन रिप्रेजेंट मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला बाय MF ऑल्सो. दिस वन इज, जस्ट सी, यू कैन रिप्रेजेंट इट बाय MF. इट्स अ कैपिटल M एंड कैपिटल F. नाउ इन केस ऑफ मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला, बेसिकली this is a formula which gives the actual number of atoms of various element present in one molecule of the compound. Okay, means how many various elements are present in a particular compound, that one is basically known as molecular formula. Okay, for example, now suppose, you know, easy one is, okay, water. Formula of water is, that one is H2O. okay, so now in this one is a molecular formula also. Okay, because number of hydrogen is 2 and oxygen is 1. Okay, then another one we have glucose. It's a C6H12O6. Now just see, this one is a formula of glucose. Now this is a molecular formula of glucose because it's not a structural formula. Okay, because this one is only giving us idea of how many elements are present in a particular compound. 6 carbon, 12 hydrogen and oxygen, again it's a 6. Okay, so this one is molecular formula. You can take another example. We have benzene. That one is C6H6. Okay, that is C6H6. It's a benzene. Okay, the molecular formula, it's not a structural formula. The carbon is 6, hydrogen is also 6. The simple molecular formula which gives the actual number of various elements present in one molecule of the compound, that one is known as molecular formula. Okay, now another one we have empirical formula. Okay, actually empirical formula which gives the simplest whole number ratio of the atoms of various elements present in one molecule. Means this one is not the actual number of elements present in compound. Okay, but this one is the simplest ratio. Okay, now just see. For example, this one is molecular formula. Now another one is empirical formula, that is represented by EF. This one will give the simplest formula, the simplest ratio of the molecular formula. Now just say, check in case of water, H2O, that empirical formula also remains same because numbers are not cancelable. Okay, so this one is also same, but in case of C6H12O6, you know, you can convert it into simplest ratio because 6 into 1, it's a 6. 6 into 2, it's a 12, and then 1. The empirical formula is CH2O because you have converted it into simplest form. Now just see, C6H6. Okay, simplest ratio is CH. So this simplest ratio of the compound of that various element in the various element of the compound, that one is known as empirical formula. Okay, hope so this one is clear. Now important thing, okay, how to calculate molecular formula and empirical formula. So first of all, for calculating molecular formula, now just see, it's a molecular formula. We have one now this one molecular formula, that is equal to n into, let's see, that is equal to n into empirical formula. This formula you have to learn, that one is molecular formula is equal to n into empirical formula. Now again question arises, what is n? Okay, how to calculate n? Now where n is equal to, basically it's a number 1, 2, 3 and so on. But you have to calculate n because generally n is not given to you. You have to calculate how. Now just see, for calculating n we have formula, that n is equal to that molecular, or either you can say molar mass, it's a molecular mass, or either it's a molar mass upon empirical formula mass. Whatever is your empirical formula, you have to calculate empirical formula mass. Okay, so this one, how to calculate n? Okay, so this one is one formula to calculate molecular mass. Now we have one short formula also, that one is, if that one is vapor density is given to you, so generally that molar mass is equal to 2 into Vd. This one is Vd, where Vd is vapor density. You know vapors, Okay, so that one is whatever is the density of vapor, that one is known as vapor density, and that molecular mass that is equal to 2 into vapor density. Okay, now these are some formula. On the basis of this, I'll tell you how to solve numerical. Now just see, okay, your first question is, now suppose your question is, the molecular mass of an organic compound is 78 and its percentage composition is 92.4% carbon and 7.6% hydrogen. Determine the molecular formula of the compound. Now, first of all, you have to check how many elements and percentages are given. Okay, if their sum is 100, then it's okay. If it's not 100, that means that third element is also present, and that one is oxygen. But just see here, the sum is 100, so it means only two elements are present. Now for this, okay, for this one, how to solve it? I'll find this method is easiest method. Instead of solving it by other method, I'll explain this only. Okay, now in this, okay, make some column. Now first column, element. Second is for percentage, whatever percentage is given. Then atomic mass. Then number of moles of atom. Here moles of atom is written, so it means it's a number of moles of atom. You know formula, given mass upon molar mass. Okay, mole ratio and simplest whole number ratio. Okay, now in this one, whatever is the elements given to you, you have to write an element name. Now this one is carbon, this one is hydrogen. Now just see, percentage is given 92.4. Okay, this one is given 7.6. Atomic mass of carbon is 12, hydrogen is 1. Keep it in mind, hydrogen atomic mass is 1. Don't take it as 2. This one is a very normal mistake. Okay, then generally students take that hydrogen is 2, but that is for H2. Here I am taking it's a hydrogen. Okay, so this one is atomic mass of single hydrogen atom is 1. Okay, now number of moles, how to calculate given mass upon molar mass. So 92.4% of 100 is 92.4. So just see, 92.4 is your given mass upon 12 atomic mass, 7.6 upon atomic mass. Calculate it, your answer is 7.7 and this one is 7.6. Now out of this, jo bhi chota number hai, now check, 7.7 is a greater number as comparison to 7.6. So jo jitne bhi numbers hain, okay, you have to divide all the numbers by smallest number in the group. Now to here 7.6 is a smaller one, so you have to divide both the term. So 7.7, okay, divided by 7.6. So just see, 7.6 and 7.6 divided by 7.6. So whatever is the number, sabko hume kisse divide karna hai, that one is the smallest number se jo bhi inke group mein present hai. Okay, so 7.7 divided by 7.6 is equal to 1.01, and here it's a 1. The simplest ratio is 1:1. Okay, it means, just see, their empirical formula is C1H1. The formula is CH. The molecular formula, you know, it's N into empirical formula. How to calculate N? It's a molar mass upon empirical formula mass. Molar mass is given, it's a 78, and empirical formula mass, carbon is 12 plus hydrogen is 1. It's a 13, and 13 into 6. Just see, that one is 78 upon 13. That one is 6, so N is equal to 6. Now put this value in molecular formula and calculate. Put this value here and calculate molecular formula. Now just see. Okay, MF is equal to 6 into CH. So your formula becomes C6H6. Okay, this one is your answer. Okay, now on this basis, try to solve one numerical. It's almost same. Okay, this one is homework for you. Now check, a compound contains 4.07% hydrogen, 24.27% carbon and itna chlorine. Its molecular mass is 98.96. What are its empirical and molecular formula? It's the same question, no change. Okay, try it. Okay, thank you.